Okay, welcome back to the channel, guys. So we're gonna take you guys along for one of my journeys today. So today I'm going to be swapping out, so I'm in my daily, the noisy dogs. I'm in my daily, and pretty much you guys would remember I have a UA4C Speeduino ECU running this car. It has been like that for a couple months. I would say maybe 6-7 months, has had zero issues. But today I'm going to be testing out another ECU sent to me by Aaron over in New York. So it's in here. It's basically his version of the Speeduino V0.4. I already have the enclosure from my other V0.4 that I'm running. So essentially today I'm going to be swapping out the UA4C to a V0.4, and then we're going to see if the V0.4, but his works just fine. I have all confidence in Aaron because I believe he does have his Nissan 240SX with an SR20 running fine on it. So it's just a series of ECUs I hope to test and work with Aaron in the future. Right, so I'm gonna fast forward and then just skip right ahead to the wiring. Okay, and this is the PCB. As you can see here, it's the DetonationEMS made by Aaron. So it's essentially just another variant of the V0.4. I think it's pretty much identical to a V0.4.3, but again, he just his own rendition of the board. I'll be using an external map sensor, pretty much just another 2.5 bar map sensor. All right, so on to the next step. Okay, so I'm just about done with the wiring. So I put the ECU back in the enclosure right here as a 3D printed end plate. And I'm using one of my V4UC connectors. So basically, as a ribbon cable plugs into here. And from here, you just have a harness going over into there. Needs to be tucked in and properly taped and tie strapped into place, but for now it'll serve its purpose. Again, I have the external map here temporarily mounted, and yeah, so if you're wondering, this is the what you would get with the V4UC kit. So it's this PCB. Let's see if I can get it out of here for you. 1 second. Alright, so it's this PCB. So basically the ribbon cable would be plugged into here with the connector, and you'd be using this to build the harness. So you'd end up with something like that. Power and ground here. Alright. So next, moving on to the laptop. So I have everything connected here. So as you can see, everything is reading okay. The exception of my map. Because I have the wrong board going from, so I'm pretty much using same project, same Arduino. I use the Arduino from the V4UC on this one. So I'm gonna go into here, not using a V4UC, UA4C, sorry, going to a V0.4. Gonna hit burn. That's not gonna need to power cycle. Sorry about the glare. So again, remove USB. Reconnect USB, close this, and now my map is reading correctly. So this, I'm expecting this to just fire right up. I don't have the white band installed on this one, but should fire right up. Okay, moment of truth. Okay, so it works. For the most part, my temp is reading correctly. RPMs are good. Wideband isn't connected, so the FL ratio is not really accurate. Yeah, so it works. So next step is to actually take it out for a drive and to monitor if everything is good. But for the most part, if it starts and it runs, then I don't see any reason why it wouldn't work. Okay, so I just got back from a short drive. I basically took about a 20-minute drive to pick up my son from school, and Detonation EMS, the V0.4, drove flawlessly. So everything is good. Again, I still don't have the wire on it, but from experience, I know that swapping from a V0.4 to a UA40 or backwards UA40 to a V0.4, generally the same tune runs a tad bit richer, if I recall correctly. That's mainly due to the injector driver they use. I believe the one for the UA40 is a bit quicker. I'm not getting it backwards, but if anything, the tune might probably need 1 or 2% pulled from it. But again, it's not anything that I would worry about. The tune wasn't on the raggedy edge as is. So the Detonation EMS gets a thumbs up. This is V1.1. I believe he's working on a V2 currently. I hope to get that soon to test out. So for the most part, this one is going to stay on the car for now. The UA40 is going to go to another project, or another one of my customer projects. And again, like you saw, I used the V4UC, the small adapter boards for the V0.4. I find it's a very easy and neat way to make a harness for the V0.4 series of boards, instead of having guys soldering directly to the board and whatnot. This one is easy and neat. Put a link down in the description where you can buy this one. It's, I think I have it for sale for about $8 US, so it's really cheap. And you don't have to solder anything to the V0.4 PCB at all. So again, you can reuse your PCB on another project without having to unsolder or anything like that. It's really cheap, so you can just get another one and make a new harness if needs be. So I've been driving this car around for a few days, and so far, absolutely no issues with the Detonation EMS Speeduino. So I pretty much have it here, just strapped into place under my dashboard. Everything is good. So off the bat, like I said, the tune did need a little adjustment switching from the UA4C Speeduino to the V0.4. I think generally it was about 2 to 3% leaner on the V0.4, so I just splashed in a tiny bit of fuel and all is well. So far, I can say that I'm super impressed with the Detonation EMS Speeduino, and I hope to be using it a lot more in the future on other projects where I get to use the V0.4. Right, so not much else to say. Gets a DCwerx thumbs up. Right, thanks, Aaron. Till the next time, guys, stay safe, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.